When you're planning your micro wedding, keep in mind that this is still your wedding date, not just a regular family gathering. Even if you're only going to have 10 guests attending, you can still make it special. Today, we're going to be talking about all the things that you can incorporate into your micro wedding that will blow your guests away. I know that there are a lot of people who are watching my videos, even though the content doesn't necessarily apply to them. You're probably single or maybe already married. If so, first of all, I really appreciate you being here just to support me. But since you're already here, while we go through the content of the video, if you can think of any other ideas for couples, drop them in the comments below. And that way, people are not just stuck listening to my ideas, but they can have help from you guys as well. Okay, are you ready? Here are all the ways that you can make your micro wedding even more unique. The first way is with the venue or location. Since you're having such a small wedding, you can get really creative with this one. And I mean, you can take your guests anywhere, places that you wouldn't even have thought of because you were originally planning to have such a big wedding. You can make your wedding a mini vacation. You don't really have to worry about inconveniencing so many guests because the people who are there are just happy to be a part of it. Now, obviously you can't travel internationally, but if you're in Alberta, you can always have your wedding in Bamford, Jasper. I know most of you have not even thought about having a wedding in the mountains before because it seemed impossible with over 500 guests. But now with less than 30 and possibly even 10 guests, it seems a lot more realistic. If that's not something that seems realistic to you or not something that really excites you, consider renting a venue like an Airbnb for an entire weekend. The reason why I say the whole weekend is because why not make your wedding last an entire weekend? If you wanted to, you can even have a different group of guests come on each day. Or you can do something really fun and use the house to have a sleepover with your siblings or friends so that you can all get ready together on the morning of the wedding. And if that idea is not for you, you can look into the outdoor venues that are available in your area. And if you're on a budget, you can get married right in your backyard or in your own living room. And you can still make it special by completely transforming the space, just like we did with this one. Because like I mentioned before, this isn't just a regular family dinner. This is your wedding day, no matter where you have it. The next thing you can do is create an experience that's personalized to the people who are attending. One way you can do that is by personalizing your wedding favors. And as much as your guests love you, I don't mean personalizing them with your names, your wedding date, or your monogram. Write their name or something special about them. But they don't have to be personalized. You can just give them something that you wouldn't necessarily have done with so many guests, like something a little bit more expensive. You can even gift each guest a welcome box just like these ones. And you can either give everyone the same thing or you can personalize it for who you're giving it to. But one of the most important things you can do to enhance the experience is splurge on food. I mean, we all know how food can either make or break a wedding. So why not do something crazy with it? I mean, if there's one thing everyone looks forward to at weddings, it's the food. And having a small wedding is the perfect opportunity to create an unforgettable dining experience. Because like I've mentioned so many times before, the biggest thing that's going to affect your budget is your guest count. And that's mainly because of catering. But now you have a small guest count, so you can do so much with that. If your wedding is at a venue, you can opt for a 5-course meal. And you know the food's not gonna go to waste because you'll have a good idea of what your guests would want. It won't be so difficult to ask them either. If your wedding's going to be at home or on private property or at a wedding venue that doesn't have in-house catering, one thing you can do is hire a personal chef who can create a luxury experience for you and your guests. And again, you can do a multi-course plated meal, or you can let the chef get really creative with a unique serving experience. Get creative with the desserts too. If you don't care for the cake cutting portion of the event, you can serve next level individual cakes to each of your guests that look like this, or something completely different that you and your guests would love. Just think about what you and your loved ones normally love to have for dessert, and then take it up a notch or two. Now we can talk about decor. I would recommend seating everyone on the same table, if possible, like I showed you in this picture earlier. And that's just because it's already such a small event, you may as well have everyone there so you can share in conversation. Pay attention to details in your place settings like charger plates, specialty dinnerware, really pretty napkins. You can even include a menu for each guest so they know what to expect with dinner. You can go over the top with your place settings because you have such a small amount of guests. For other aspects of decor, prioritize statement pieces with florals or lighting or even both. I personally am really inspired by these photos, but make it your own. I've said it a couple times before, but I'm going to say it again. This is your wedding. Have fun with it. Get creative. You're saving money in so many other areas, so you might as well do something a little bit outside of the box. The last thing I'm going to suggest is to be very intentional about the activities that you have planned. It might be a little awkward to include dancing in your program if you only have a small number of guests. If dancing is something you generally like to do with that group of people, then definitely keep it. But if you're not so sure and you're worried that your guests might not be into it, then you might want to remove it completely. Instead, think about what would make the overall experience enjoyable. And that might just just mean having a very nice dinner like we just talked about. But if you want more, you can always plan a fun adventure or activities to do with your guests. And I don't know about you, but I'm thinking something crazy like helicopter or hot air balloon rides. But that's probably a little bit too much. So you can do something a little bit more practical like having a bonfire or karaoke or something fun like that. It all depends on your budget and what you and your guests would actually have fun doing. But relieve the pressure you have on yourself to entertain them. These are your guests, they love you and they're happy to be there. Just create an environment that will allow you to enjoy each other's company because that's what matters the most. Now that we've gone through everything, comment below and let me know which ideas you're most excited about incorporating into your micro wedding. And don't forget to like and subscribe if you haven't already. Thank you so much for listening and I'll see you next week with another video.
I just wanna love you, just wanna hold you, just wanna be with you till we grow old.